What is up, you guys? I hope you're doing well in dark times. I'm Tony Fuentes, and today we're editing moody style landscape photography and nature photography with the style of Dylan First. Now, if you don't know who Dylan First is, he's a creator based in Bellingham, Washington. And as we can see, his style resembles all kinds of cold vibes and moody vibes. We can see a lot of blues, some greens, a lot of nature photography of eagles and other wildlife, as well as we can see beautiful landscapes with all the mist, all the clouds, and some portraits mixed in there. So let's see his style and uncover a bit of the details. Then we're gonna jump into Lightroom, create a preset, and edit some photos. Okay, so this is Dylan First on Instagram. You can go and follow him. And as we can see, his style is very moody, very coldish, a lot of misty days and cloudy nights. But throughout, we can see a consistency in his colors. We can see some greens in some cases and some blues. More than that, we don't see any warmish colors or anything resembling a warm day. Now, his nature photography is quite fantastic, and as we can see, the owl has had some retouching with the brush tool in Lightroom. Now, the shadows and the midtones have blue in them, so we're gonna edit that. That's in camera calibration from his trip to the Antarctica. Well, this is Greenland, and this is beautiful, a beautiful shot. But his style stays consistent with the colors, a very curated style. Again, the eagle, what a beautiful photograph. And we keep scrolling through this magical, moody profile. We can see that even the landscapes in the desert don't escape from the cold tones in the shadows and in the midtones. Again, a beautiful image of this bald eagle. And we can see that the brush tool has been used with some clarity and some exposure in all of the animal and the tree branch. And in this case, we can see some green tones instead of blue tones around this bird. Beautiful, beautiful work. And we keep scrolling through this beautiful profile. Again, very nice. Okay, so let's jump into Lightroom and see how to edit this. Okay guys, so these are the photographs that we're gonna edit. I don't have any wildlife photography, so photos of my dogs in the forest will have to do. So in this case, I'm gonna start with this one of my dog Emmett, go to the develop tab, and for starters, I'm gonna make the image a bit more dark with a minus 0.6 on the exposure. Now we're gonna go to the highlights, another plus 10, and the shadows with a 90. Now the whites are just gonna go up just a little bit, so plus 10, that controls all the whitest parts of the image, and the minus 14 in the blacks to make it a bit more contrast. Now down in presence clarity, we're gonna up it up to a plus 16, not too much, otherwise the image will look too much contrasty and blown out. So just a 16. And vibrance is gonna go to a minus 8, while saturation is gonna go down to a minus 7. Now to a tone curve, we're gonna return further along, as well as to the HSL tabs and split toning. Right now, I want to go all the way down to camera calibration. Now, camera calibration affects the colors that come from the camera, so many editors will tell you not to mess with it. But in this case, we just want to make Dylan First style, so we're gonna move it. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do is move the greens. If we move the greens up and down, we can see that it makes it towards the minus 100 a bit more warmish, and to the other side a bit more to the emeralds. And that's what we're gonna do, plus 100, and we're gonna desaturate it just a bit to a minus 7. So the blues are gonna go up to a plus 20, and the minus 12 as well in desaturation. Now the reds affect also the greens. We can see it if we move it the slider up and down. We're just gonna move it up to a plus 19 and just gonna leave it right there. Maybe desaturate just a bit, minus 5. Okay, we can see what the camera calibration is done by clicking this button on and off. And it's looking pretty nice. Now we are going to return to the HSL colors. And in this case, in saturation, we're just gonna desaturate completely the magentas and purples. These colors don't appear at all on Dylan First's images. Just gonna leave it like that. And in hue, we're gonna change the aquas towards the blues with a plus 90, and the greens all the way to the emeralds to a plus 100. Just like that, that's all we're gonna do in hue. And now in luminance, we're just gonna deilluminate a bit of the colors with a minus 20 for the yellows, a minus 10 for the greens, a minus 10 again for the aquas, and a minus 20 for the blues. We can see what we've done by clicking the button, and it's looking very nice. With Y on our keyboard, we can see what we've done so far. Very good. Now let's go down to split toning, and here we're gonna assign a color to the highlights and the shadows. In this case, we're gonna type in 230 in both of them, and just amp up a bit of the saturation. In the highlights, we're gonna amp up to 5. And if we move the saturation up, we can see with what color we're working. And it's a very intense blue. So now let's go down to 14 in saturation. Okay, it's looking a bit more blue. Okay, next up, the tone curve. Now in the tone curve, what we're gonna do is mark 3 points. one in the middle, one in the middle tones of the highlights, and one in the middle tones of the shadows. Okay, we're gonna pull this one just a little bit up, this one just a little bit up. And then if we look closely on Dylan First's images, we can see that the blacks aren't pure blacks. We can see a little bit of grayish. So we're gonna pull up just a little this last point, so it's a bit more gray, just like that. Happy with that. And it's looking pretty nice. Okay, now I'm gonna crop it 4x5. Okay, and next up, I'm gonna add a vignette, Playa minus 20. And as we can see, there's a little more subject isolation. Now in all photographs of animals, Dylan, what he does is retouches with a brush tool. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. First of all, we're gonna zoom in to the eyes, select the brush tool, add a little bit more exposure and sharpness, and let's color the pupils of the dog, just like that, ever so slightly. And as we can see, the eyes now glow and have a little bit more impact. Now next up, and with a brush tool again, we're gonna add some exposure to highlight certain parts of the dog. In this case, I'm just gonna highlight a bit of the things that are already highlighted, just like this. So he pops up just a little bit more. Once finished, you can enter. And there we have it, a beautiful image. Now if we want to make this image a lot more bluish, we can see that Dylan has two types of images, the green ones tend towards the green tones and the ones that tend towards a bluish tone. So if we wanted to make it a lot more bluish, we can drop down the temperature just a little bit more. Just around there. And if we want to do the opposite, we can pull it just a little bit up. And as we can see, the image is a lot more greenish. Now we can do this right here, or we can go down to the curves as well and select here the blue curve. Now in blue, what we're gonna do is pull up this point just around there. And we can see that everything in the image, midtones, highlights, acquires this blue tone. Now I'm gonna return it, and we can do it the same with the green curve, just around there. Okay, it looks very nice. Now I'm gonna save this one as Dylan First green, and then I'm gonna save another one with the blue. Now let's see the before and after. Okay, it looks pretty good. Now let's see it applied to other photographs. In this case, this is Lupita, my dog, she's deaf. Now let's see how it applies the green one and the blue one. Very nice, I'm gonna leave it with the green one. And in this case as well, just like before, I'm gonna zoom in and add a little bit more exposure with the brush tool, just around there, just to make her pop a little bit more. And I'm very happy with this image. Next up, this is my dog Arnor. I'm gonna apply the blue one in this case, or the green one, I don't know, maybe the blue one. Maybe I'm gonna drop this time the blues to make it a lot more natural, just around there. And of course, I'm gonna edit the eyes as well. Very nice. Okay, let's apply it to some plants. Okay, so this little plant growing, I'm gonna apply the blue one or the green one, whichever. And of course, I'm gonna amp up just a little bit the exposure and just ever so slightly color the little plant. Very nice image. Next up, apply the green one or the blue one. In this case, the preset works very nicely with just a little one click. Another one, we have to amp up a bit of the exposure. Okay, and it's looking very nice. Once again, let's apply the blue one in this case. Amp up the exposure just a bit. Quite nice, very nice indeed. Last one, let's apply the green one or the blue one, just around there. In this case, again, I'm gonna zoom in, add some clarity to the dog himself, just like that, very nice. Now I'm gonna zoom in just a lot more and add some clarity to the eyes, just around there. I'm done. Okay, so we've accomplished the preset, actually two presets, one for green tones and one for blue tones, and it applies perfectly to nature and landscape photography. And that's it for this tutorial, guys. Remember to go and support Dylan on Instagram. I'm Tony Fuentes. If you did like the video, can you please give it a like? It really makes a difference, and consider subscribing. Remember to hit the notification bell to be notified when I upload the next video. I'm Tony Fuentes. Cheers to all of you, and see you in the next one.